Hello kids, I hope you all are fine and staying safely at home. So kids, as you remember, we have started with the chapter The Story of Village Palampur, and we have done with the factors of production, farming activities, land distribution and capital requirement. So today we will discuss about sale of surplus farm products and non-farming activities in Palampur. Let's move to the topic. So first topic is sale of surplus farm products. Let's do this topic with an example. Let us suppose a farmer produced a wheat by using three factors of production. Now, farmer will keep a part of wheat for family consumption and sell the rest of the part of wheat, which is known as surplus wheat, in the market. So, it is a medium and large farmers who supply wheat to the market and get their earnings. This surplus money farmers can deposit in the bank or can use for further investment, or they can lend the money to the small farmers. Now let's understand this more clearly with an example, with an activity. So here we have to compare three farmers and their production. Let's read out this statement. Let us take three farmers. Each has grown wheat on his field, though the production is different. The consumption of wheat by each farmer family is the same. The whole of surplus wheat this year is used as capital for next year production. Also, suppose production is twice the capital used in the production. I'm repeating, production is twice the capital used in the production. Let's do the farmer one. In the year one, production is 100 and the consumption they kept for the family, that is 40. So surplus formula is production minus consumption, that is 100 minus 40 is 60. It means they are having capital in their hand for the next year is 60. Now, as they told earlier, the production is twice the capital used in the production. So 60 into 2 is 120. So year 2, production will be 120. So consumption is 40. So surplus formula will be production minus consumption. So 120 minus 40 will be 80. So the capital they are having in their hand for next year is 80. Same now again, 80 into 2 will be 160. So year 3 production is 160. So consumption is 40. So surplus will be 160 minus 40 will be 120. The capital they are having in their hand is 120. So kids, same way farmer 2 and farmer 3, you have to solve it. And then you have to solve the question which they have asked by based on these table. Now move to the next topic, that is non-farming activities. So here the question arises, what are non-farming activities? So answer is, non-farming activities are those which do not include farming as a source of income. Like first is given dairy. Dairy is a common activity in Palampur. People used to sell milk in Raiganj and nearby villages. Second is given an example of small-scale manufacturing in Palampur. In village, less than 50 people are engaged in this activity. It involves very simple production methods and are done on very small scale. Let's take some more example from the village. As Mishrilal has purchased a mechanical sugarcane crushing machine and set up in his field only, and Karim has opened computer class center in the village at small level. So from these example, it's clear that which type of small scale manufacturing they are having in their village. So kids, as you can see, here are some questions related to these examples. So you can get these questions answer from the PDF file which are going to be attached after this lecture. So third is given the non-farm activity in Palampur, which is the shopkeeper of Palampur. So the traders of Palampur are shopkeeper who buy various goods from wholesale market in the city, from the city, and sell them in the villages. There is small general stores who are selling items like biscuits, soaps, toothpaste, batteries and candles, etc. Now move to the next example, that is given transport, which is a fast developing sector. So as let's take one example to understand it. As Kishora is a farm laborer, he bought a buffalo with his money. He used to sell buffalo's milk. Then he attached a wooden cart with his buffalo and start using it as his transport in the market. Now he is able to earn more money as he was earning as a farm laborer. So from here we can understand how the transport system is more developing in the village Palampur. Now, in the end of this chapter, end of this lesson, in the whole we can say that farming is a main production activity. By the time, there have been many changes. Now, they have multiple cropping, modern farming methods. Next, we have learned that small farmers are getting money from the large farmers as they're borrowing money. And the large farmers and the medium farmers, they're having their own savings from their own village. From their own farming, sorry. So, in the rather than this, village Palampur also has non-farming activities like transport, dairy, shopkeeping, etc. which are at small scale now. But it is possible that the opportunities for non-farm activities in the villages would increase in coming years. So, with this, we are going to end this chapter. So, kids, question answer of this chapter you can get in next PDF file. Till then, thank you. Stay alert, stay safe, stay home.